I'm back on the road. I left Kenmore and I was going to cross to Montana today, but Chili's chain is gone. I mean, it's bad. So there is a bike shop in Calgary that has DID chains and they'll be able to fit it for me tomorrow. So we're going to Calgary today. A little bit of a detour. We're going back to the Big Smoke. Let's see Calgary, because I actually only landed in Calgary once and I didn't really see it. So yeah, let's see what's in town. Made it to Calgary. It was only like 100 k's on a highway and now we're here. It's very warm. We've got 34 degrees. But anyway, so my plan is I just wanted to see the downtown. I will not stop. I was just gonna drive through it because it's just too hot to walk around. And then yeah, pretty much I'll go to the motel, crash for the night, tomorrow fix my chain and get out of here. Okay, I think this is it. This is like the heart of downtown Calgary. Very cool, right? Actually, it's bigger than I thought it was. Nice. And here we see the city tower, just like in Sydney, but shorter, I think. Looks like it. That's it, this is the tower. Huh, good concrete. Okay, we're out of downtown now. That was it, the end of the tour. And somewhere here we'll have Chili chain changed. Where are these guys? They're gonna be somewhere on the left. And that one. Excellent. Chili, we'll probably keep you here.
How's my hair, Dave?
Your hair looks wonderful.
Thank you. Oh, don't mention it.
I used to have hair like that.
Actually, no, I went to the hairdresser. So this is Dave. Dave, look after Chili. Oh, hold on. Are you in a frame? Yes, you are. Okay, cool. Yes, so you're the owner of the shop.
I am.
Thank you so much for fitting me in. I know you guys are very, very busy because it is summer.
Always have room for travelers.
Thank you. That's so nice of you. So we've changed Chili chain. We fixed her.
GPS mount,
and we've changed oil. Excellent service, thank you so much.
She's good to go.
Thank you.
Okay, Chili. You'll be running now like brand new with a new chain. It was nice to meet you, see ya. Okay. Cool! Oh, you are running excellent now with a new chain. Okay, next stop in Calgary will be not too far from here. We've got 15 minutes to go. We're going to see Cory from Camel Tank, my very, very first sponsor. Well, he's not my official sponsor now, but he was the first guy who ever gave me free stuff. And we are nearly here. Somewhere here. one of these doors. We're looking for Camel ADV products, Chili. No. 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 Huh. I'm not sure. No. This is it. Must be it. Does this look like motorcycle parts workshop? Yeah, totally. That's us.
We finally met. So we would try to trace it back. I think it was 2014 when you contacted me.
It could be.
Cory and Camel ADV products. At the time, I think it was always Camel ADV products. I think it was Camel Tank. Was your
no,
very
it was always,
first?
It was Camel always ADV. Camel ADV because I knew that I wasn't just going to do gas tanks.
And your first product was Camel Tank. Yes, that one. And I was still living in Australia. I just did a trip around Australia, and Cory contacted me. Hey, you want to test the product? So that was the very first sponsorship, very first sponsored product I ever received. Thank you very much for that.
No problem.
That tank was on my previous GS that got written off in a head-on collision with a car. The tank has survived. I put it on Chile, and I traveled with it until last summer. So I reckon 10 years in total I was using it on both bikes, around 150,000 kilometers. Mm-hmm. Pretty impressive. Yes. And yesterday you sent me the new one because the other one was getting a bit worn out. And now we are changing the housing because I just calculated the housing is 180,000 kilometers old. And there's nothing wrong with it, but we might as well change it, right?
You're here.
That's right. We're drilling a hole?
We're drilling holes a little bit bigger.
Okay.
So it's just a different brand of hose, so it's a little bit bigger OD.
Nice.
So the hole that
we can do
you
that.
Have there.
That's fine. Yeah. I know you know what you're doing. So this is it. This is the hose that I've used for so long. It's still good, right?
It's still soft, yeah. It's not brittle. It's not cracked.
Yeah. Maybe because it was continuously used. Maybe, you know, it's just constantly on a move. And that vent. Oh, that's going to be my new vent?
That is your new vent.
Oh, wow.
The other
this is the
like
new one? And this is the old one. This is the difference. It used to be like that. Have to put everything together. Look at you, Chili. You are so refreshed after today. Good spa day for you, mate. And your cup. Uh-huh. That is it here. So.
Oh no, I think we do.
Oh,
because it's
done.
Hooray.
Hooray. So pretty. Okay, straight, make it straight. Can you get this? Focus, focus. The other one wasn't that straight. Oh, look at that. And that's so straight. That's okay. If you look like this, it's straight. So Chili is good to go, but Cory, I have to ask you questions.
Okay.
Come here. I'm finding better lighting for you and you can see all your beautiful workshop. Right. Yes. Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So as I mentioned, we go way back. I'm pretty much, yeah, I was like, yeah, I could say I was your ambassador from like very start, right? And which year did you?
Ambassador.
Yeah, right at the time, at least for Australia at the time. Anyway, so in which year did you start Camel ADV products?
2013, so 10 years this year.
Right. So you started with a Camel tank, and where this idea came from?
I was on a round the world bike trip with a friend of mine, who was on a BMW 1200 GSA. So he had a 36-liter fuel tank, and I had my F800, which was like a 16-liter tank. So I was always out of fuel, and it made me mad. So just decided to make an auxiliary fuel tank for the bike. And we were in Kazakhstan, and there were wild camels. And so the idea just kind of took shape there.
That's it. And so that's how we started. You came back and
started.
So you started with camel tanks for all sorts of adventure bikes. And since then, you expanded your product range. So what else do you have? Do you want to show us?
Yeah, for sure. Not everything is here, but we have a full line of stuff for the T7.
Okay,
so
yeah, let's do that.
Skid plates, camel tank, exhaust, foot pegs, high fender kits. We've got a bunch of stuff for the Touareg. Or not a bunch yet, but...
Woohoo, I like
woo-hoo,
that.
The big reveal.
Yeah, I like that bike. I was riding it a few days back.
Right, yeah. So we've got the skid plate for the Touareg, the high fender kit.
So this one you're literally manufacturing here in Calgary.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yep. And then you have foot pegs.
Yep, you bet.
Thank you so much for not doing them for 800GS. Chili's very, very unhappy with you.
Sorry.
That's okay.
Don't have them all covered.
At least I have new hoses.
No, good.
And what else you have?
Yeah, so Desert X, skid plate for the Desert X high fender kit as well. We've got some luggage racks coming for that bike too.
So basically you're focusing now for kitting up most popular bikes, right, on the market?
Yeah, the middleweight twins, really.
And do you ship out all around the world, or is just Canada is your main market?
No, the U.S. is the main market. Mind. So Canada, the U.S., Australia, those are kind of the big three.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have dealers for the rest of the world. So we don't ship direct to Europe anymore. We have dealers for that.
Ah, that was a light one this time. Hold on, I fix my hair. How is it?
Am I fixing my hair?
Yes. Let's not forget about Katy.
Okay.
Katy was our helper and our camerawoman. Cory's partner, Katy. Yes. Lovely. Yeah. There you go. Hello. Welcome on YouTube. Thank you for filming for us.
Guys, thank you so much. Thank you for your support. Thank you for squeezing me and, you know, doing this little hosing upgrade for Chili. I absolutely love your product. It's been with me since the beginning of my pretty much, you know, adventure riding, right? I had Camel Tang on my previous bike, and now around the world with Chili. I think it's a great product. Thank you for supporting me.
There's one more thing I want to see before I leave Calgary. And this is it. The Olympic ski jump from Calgary Olympics back in the days. Where is the best view? I think maybe this way.
So I had to come here because it's sort of like a sentimental location for me. And the reason for that is, well, it goes all the way to my childhood. So the only Olympics games I remember from my childhood were Calgary Winter Olympics. And the reason for that is they had this the cutest teddy ever as an Olympics mascot. Like with a hat and all, so Canadian. And I was hoping, like, you know, maybe he's around somewhere, but Teddy is nowhere to be found here. But it was still worth to see the location where it all happened in 88. Yeah, so I'll show you, there's a monument, there's like a ski jump, there's lots of things happening these days in this location. So yeah, this is the last attraction of Calgary. So this will be my last commentary from Canada. I'm about to cross the border and I'm being very emotional because I just had the best time in this country. So in total, you know, last summer combined with this summer, I spent 5 months in Eastern provinces and West provinces. And I just absolutely had a fantastic time. I bond with Canadians like this. Yeah, Canadians and I were like this. Just my type of people. So I'm gonna miss you all deeply. Thank you all for all the great memories. I will be back one day, just don't know when, so that's why I'm so sad. Anyway, time to cross to the USA.
I'm ready.
The light is good here, but we and now it's not a good light. Hold on, maybe this way. Ah, oh, we got our camera. Okay, maybe this way. Okay, this way. Right. Okay. Okay, we're ready. One, two, three. Yamaha in the background. There you go. A little bit of promo for you. We go like this.